Guys, this is Blessing Njo, aka Mrs. Ejim, and today is Bobrisky Day.
Bobrisky is a highly controversial 28-year-old Nigerian crossdresser. He deals in female clothing and cosmetics.
This video is for some idiots on my page. I'm going to post a picture. You will tell me, you look good, bro. Where is your bro? Please, Tani bro, your bro is in Yaba collecting treatment. I am a beautiful girl. So if I post a picture and you feel you want to comment, you comment and say, you look beautiful, baby girl, pretty woman. Don't call to my brother and tell me, bro. Who is your bro?
I'm not going to presume everybody knows who Bobrisky is, but if you pick an average Nigerian and ask him or her who Bobrisky is, they are going to tell you exactly who they think he is. But is their assumption about the personality Bobrisky really accurate? Is it really a representation of the person that he truly is? So here is what I did. I carried out a research on Bobrisky because there is a national confusion about Bobrisky's sexuality. And to be honest, it's really nobody's business who Bobrisky is doing it with. But what makes his case unique? What makes him special? Why he's such a person of interest for me to be vlogging about is the fact that he is a Nigerian that lives in an ultra-conservative nation like Nigeria. And in Nigeria, you risk 14 years imprisonment if you're homosexual. But there is a clause to that law, and that is you have to be caught in the act. So you coming out simply saying I'm gay doesn't mean that you're going to be charged or prosecuted. You'd have to be caught in the act. So as long as Bobrisky is not caught in front of a man or behind a man, he's covered. So today I have really come to the discovery of who Bobrisky truly is and why he is the way that he is. So if you are somebody who has been wondering, what is this guy all about? Or you know someone who is always asking questions about Bobrisky, or you know someone who hates Bobrisky because there are so many Nigerians who detest him, who feel like he's a bad example to the young generation and that he's really creating this new lifestyle of cross-dressing that really doesn't go down well with a whole lot of people in that country. So I'm going to tell you about Bobrisky, from where he came from when he was born, till how he became the Bobrisky that we all know. So Bobrisky is actually from a polygamous family. His father was a Muslim. His real names are Idris Okuneye Olanrewaju. And his father had three wives, but his mom was the youngest wife. The first wife had six children, the second wife had one child, and his mom had three children, Bobrisky also being the youngest of his mom's children. But they are originally from a place called Ijebu Igbo in Nigeria. But Bobrisky himself was born in Ebutemeta, a place in Lagos. But after, I think it was around when he was in primary school that his father built a house in the Ijebu area of Lagos State. And that's where Bobrisky grew up. So right from when Bobrisky was a child, Bobrisky was already showing feminine traits. Bobrisky was always doing things that a girl child would naturally do. He was always wearing his mom's wigs. He would wear his mom's heels. His mom would beat him for that, punish him for that. He loved to cook. He loved to clean the house. He loved to take care of the family. He was really, really in tune with, you know, the very feminine chores and domestic work and all of that. So his mom became very, very fond of him. And then his mom started to accept who he was because she was eventually tired of always beating him for behaving like a girl instead of, you know, a normal male child like she would expect. And eventually she accepted him, and, you know, she was a clothier and she was a society lady. She loved to go out, she loved partying. And then whenever she dressed up, she would go to Bobrisky and ask him, like, okay, how do I look? How do you think I should combine my colors? Do you think this headgear goes with what I'm wearing? What do you think about my shoe color? And Bobrisky would actually offer advice, like very good advice to his mom as to how to dress and which colors to use and all whatnot. So that really became part of him. He became very fashion conscious. He loved fashion. He loved beautiful dresses. He loved female dresses. But he was still growing up with friends and with his family, and he was still, you know, looking like a normal child. But everyone just saw in him that this guy, you behave like a girl, you know. It was just, it has always been that way with Bobrisky. But he was still, like I said, a normal bloke. He was not dressing in female outfits. He was just, you know, growing up in a regular neighborhood and doing his thing, going to school. So in 2009, his mom went to Mecca on a pilgrimage, and unfortunately she didn't come back alive. She died while abroad. So things started getting a bit shaky for the family financially, because his mom was very well to do. When the mom passed away, she was actually already separated from the dad. So Bobrisky was growing up with his dad, but during vacations, school holidays, he would be with his mom. So that was how he tried to strike a balance between both sides. But his mom's death kind of like affected the entire family financially, because his mom was always a source of financial support to his dad. So then Bobrisky started to hustle, you know, he had to survive. And then on a fateful day, I guess he was just fooling around with his friends, and then one of his friends said, you know what, I dare you to walk down the road dressed like a woman. And was like, what do I get for that in return if I do that? And then they're like, okay, we are gonna give you 3,000 naira each. And 3,000 naira is about $10. And then Bobrisky fell for it. Actually, there were two boys who dared him. So they both promised $10 each. And then he went for it. He went and got a dress. And then in the evening, he dressed up. He wore a wig, he wore heels, you know, just to hustle, just to make money out of it. So he was walking down the street, and then an old man, you know, like all the sugar daddies, all these randy old men who go chasing after small girls, he saw Bobrisky, and he thought Bobrisky was a girl, because Bobrisky had this fake, I think it was, he had two sacks of water, what they call pure water in Nigeria. He had them inside his bosom. So they really looked real, they looked natural, and then the man fell for what he was seeing. So he called him, he called him. I'm just gonna stick to him. I don't wanna get confused, yeah? So he called him like, hey girl, fine girl, how are you doing? You know how this old dirty men toast young girls? So Bobrisky went to him and was like, oh, I'm fine. According to Bobrisky himself, he was really terrified. He was afraid of what was to come. But he continued, you know, chatting with the man and really making a conversation. So the man was like, okay, I like you, and what's your name? I would like to, you know, be friends with you. And they kept talking, but the man was suspicious, like, there's something fishy about this boy. So he called, I think, his younger sister and told her to go check him out. So the girl went and tried to, you know, get really cozy with him, try to play with him. Oh, fine girl, how are you? My uncle likes you. So she was like feeling him, trying to, you know, see what was up. And then she eventually realized that, okay, this is really not a girl. So she went back to her uncle and told him that this guy is just trying to play you. So the uncle raised alarm. And then the police came, people gathered, he created a scene, and then the police whisked Bobrisky away. So that night he spent the night in police custody, and the news broke. I think that is one of the events that catapulted Bobrisky to stardom, because everyone was talking about it. You know, this man that was trying to pretend he's a girl, trying to rip men of their money. So Bobrisky just moved on, and then in 2011 he gained admission into the University of Lagos, where he went and studied accounting. And then while he was in school, he was still hustling, you know how boys do, looking for money, trying to sustain himself, pay his college fees, pay tuition fee, and all of that. So he was able to start up a boutique. He was selling female dresses, and he was still a normal guy. He was still dark-skinned, he was still dressing like a boy, but he still had his natural inborn feminine traits and characteristics, physical ones though. So in 2014, he went to Dubai. He was on vacation there. And then he decided to buy a cream just to, you know, tone up a bit. He didn't want to bleach. It was never Bobrisky's intention to bleach. He just wanted something to brighten up his skin. He was very, very dark in complexion. So he just wanted something to clean him up a little bit. And then he started using that cream, and then that cream damaged his entire skin. Like, it gave him patches, it gave him double colors, triple colors. He had all these dark knuckles. It really, really made him ugly. And then when he saw what was going on, he decided, you know what? I just have to take care of this. I just have to control this damage. And then that was how Bobrisky started to bleach, because he had to just clean out everything. He had to bleach away the dark patches. So he started bleaching, and then he went to the US a few years later, and then he got better creams, and then started to do research about skin lightening creams, about bleaching creams, because he didn't want to fall into the same trap that he fell into when he bought the wrong cream in Dubai. So he got very interested in that study. So he decided to start a cream selling business. So that is how Bobrisky actually got into the business of selling bleaching creams. So Bobrisky went back to Nigeria. He started making a name for himself. He would go on interviews and talk about him having a boyfriend. That was actually very shocking to Nigerians, that this boy would come out and publicly say that he had a boyfriend. And people were wondering why Bobrisky never got arrested, you know, because this guy was publicly coming out to say, you know what, I am gay. Yes, I get it from behind and it's nobody's business, but nobody was doing anything about it. So people are wondering, okay, is this a case of double standards? Because you'd see a nobody being ridiculed by the police, but Bobrisky, with his celebrity status, he was like untouchable. But the point here is that as a Nigerian, as long as you do not get caught in the act, nobody has the power to touch you. So Bobrisky was selling bleaching cream, he was selling female clothing, and then he started to wear the things that he was selling to demonstrate or to promote his business, which was working for him. And then the thing actually got out of hand, because I don't think it was ever Bobrisky's intention to change his gender. So Bobrisky went as far as taking hormonal shots.
Because I'm on a drug, and the drug is reducing my male hormones in my body. It's giving me this girly, lovely shape. I bought the drug in the States when I was in America, and it's working. That's why you can see my body's changing, the shape is changing, the waist is coming out.
And that explains why he has started to change physically. You can see that his face is no longer the masculine face that we were accustomed to when Bobrisky started being thrown at our faces. He now dresses like a woman. He even learned to do his own makeup to, you know, be on fleek. So the big question I'm here to answer today is whether or not Bobrisky is gay. The answer is that Bobrisky is not gay. Bobrisky started out as a crossdresser. That got out of hand because he started to use himself as his muse to promote his business. He sells clothes, he sells body cream and other cosmetic products. So he was using himself as his own model to sell his market.
I'm not gay though, like I told you guys earlier. I'm into fashion. I put on what I want, what I'm wearing to advertise what I do. And don't worry, in the next 5 years, you see Bobrisky is getting married. It's all fine, girl.
Please invite me.
And my makeup will not be there anymore. This hair will go. Everything will disappear. Nails disappear. Then I want to be serious. I want to have my own kids. I once had a girlfriend, but we broke up because she was like, Idris, I can't continue this any longer.
And I can tell you that Bobrisky is inside of his mind. He's not even female, and he knows that he's a man. And Bobrisky is even looking forward to getting married to a woman. He's looking forward to having kids.
But I think it's very, very important for you to have your own kids. You can do whatever you want, anything you want, if you like, anything. But just make sure you have your own kids that will call you father.
So the entire Bobrisky facade is just a business strategy. So please, guys, leave this boy alone to sell his market. Leave this boy alone to do his business. Bobrisky is going to shock the entire continent on the day he gets married. So guys, start prepping yourselves. And I have to say, I know a lot of people hate on Bobrisky. They hate his personality. They hate the fact that he's cross-dressing and that he's a bad influence according to them. But you know what? Live and let live. Let the boy do his thing. As long as he's not forcing his actions down your throat. Just let him be him. And I know that might be a little controversial in a country that is against homosexuality, and I'm a supporter of the fact that you have to obey the laws of the land in which you live. Bobrisky lives in Nigeria, and he just has to adapt to the laws and the constitution of Nigeria. So I cannot wait to break the news of Bobrisky's wedding to you guys when the time comes. Guys, that brings me to the end of today's session. I will see you guys again next Sunday.